you cut them all out the same direction. If you're unsure which side's which, make sure you just use your hand to figure out which way the gnat goes. There we go. And you're both layers together. Again, I'm still using this Muppet foot, which you could use a standard foot now because this side does not have the fur on it. Or the whatever you want to call that stuff that comes out of the fabric. And you'll, as you're stitching, just hold the fabric together to make sure that one side isn't sliding one to the other. This is especially true if you're using just a standard foot. Okay. And now when I have this, I will press this open, but when you're pressing this back, press your foot and just start stitching, okay? All I'm doing is just trying to get around this fabric. Again, I'm using an odd color so you can see this. And then this is a really bad looking circle, but you'd be using glue so you wouldn't be able to tell. But I'm just going to go around each one of these. And this is what I did on the black skirt. And I'll just do a few more so I can explain why I'm doing this. If you get close to one, you can actually go around more than one at the same time. And then what I didn't include stitches, I'm going to show you this, it's a little messy looking, but as I went from one to the other, you will notice that it's all in blue, but I would cut my thread and then move over to these. So a couple more things here. As you do this, the reason I'm doing this is if I hold this up, notice how the fabric, if this was left open, this could start gapping. So you're walking, you're sitting in your skirt, and all of a sudden you have a big gap, that would not be so attractive. So this is connecting the fabric almost like it's its own fabric. That's why I have a contrasting color. So on the back side, all it looks like is this, something very simple. And if you're having a hard time holding these together because this fabric does get a little icky while you're moving it around, you can use temporary adhesive spray on the back of this to attach it. Just make sure that you don't get any of that on the part that shows through because it might show. So let me just get back here and show you a couple more things. So here's my panel. On the cutting machine, you can cut all the way down. When I'm finished, and I only allow this to cut a few of these, but I can at least show you what it ends up looking like. You'll pull away your fabric. Let's see. And this is what you'll end up with. This one, I didn't allow it to finish cutting because I had stopped it. But you'll end up with little, whatever you have, it'll stay like that. Place it on the fabric. And the only other thing is if you're having a problem keeping your fabric on this mat, there are extra things that you can have that will make it stickier to hold your fabric on there. So that's how simple it is.